Hello guys, welcome back to a new Genshin Impact gameplay video. In this video guys, I'm gonna have a guide about stats. So what are the stats, which of the stats are more important, and also some different builds for gear that include weapon and artifacts guys, because those are very important also. So let's get started guys. So all characters have stats. And the main stats, as you can see, we have HP, which will increase your maximum health. The higher it is, the less, the more time will take for the monster to kill you. So having higher HP, it counts also. Then you have attack, as you can see right here, 264 right now. Attack, guys, what it does. So attack, it's one of the most important stats. Why? Because this will increase the damage you do. There are other stats that also relate to damage, but this is the most important. The higher the attack, the more damage you do. And not just with the physical attacks, I'm gonna test, and I think it's also related to the to your skills, okay, to your attributes, the different types of elements. So that also is affected. If I'm gonna test and gonna see if that is true, but that's what I think. And defense, guys, another very important stat that is related to how less damage, so it mitigates the damage, it reduces the damage that you take from the enemy's attacks. So the higher the defense, the less damage you'll take. Okay, those are the three basic stats. Then you have elemental mastery, guys. So elemental mastery, that will increase the damage of different elements for each character, plus guys will also increase the combo of the elements, because you have different combos. I'm gonna do a separate video. When you mix two or more different elements from different characters, you can create a more powerful effect. That's a combo, okay. And stamina also. Stamina is also super important. Why? Stamina you use whenever you run, whenever you jump, whenever you climb, whenever you swim, when you fly. So stamina is very important, and you can gain stamina from leveling up, also from unlocking the seven stars, the seven the statues of seven stars. Statues of seven, yeah, seven stars, these ones, okay. If you level them up, okay, they will give you also stamina. So stamina, it's another important stat, okay. And then if we go to details, guys, and I'm gonna show you how you can level these ones up and which ones you should focus more, and let's check the details to see more advanced, okay. So you can see here, elemental mastery, the higher a character element mastery, the stronger element energy that can be released. Increased damage caused by vaporize, melt, see? Also increased damage caused by overload, superconduct, and so on. Also increase the damage absorption power of shield created through crystallized by. So you'll see the, depending on, for me it's 42, the higher the number, the higher will be those percentages, okay? Then we have advanced stats like critical rate and critical damage. These also are super important stats, because after, first you need to focus on the attack, okay? That's very important. Attack, maybe defense and HP, but attack mainly. But then if you further want later to towards the high end, like when you reach higher level, when you should focus on these stats also, critical rate and critical damage. So critical rate will increase the chance to land a critical strike. What is a critical strike? It's an increased damage, and the percentage increase is this critical damage, see here, by 53.3. so you'll do by 53.3 more damage. For me it's 53.4, you can be higher or lower, but you can increase this stat, the critical damage. So critical damage is the percentage of the increased damage you do, and critical rate is the chance to do that extra damage. Then we have also healing bonus, which will, as you know, it will heal your health, okay? So that's what healing bonus. So whenever you have a healing effect or one of your from your party, one of your characters, with it will do a healing effect, then you'll get a higher percentage, okay? The higher the healing bonus is. No, actually for incoming heals, these are from your other characters, and this is from your own character. Yeah, so healing bonus is just related to your own character, the character that you use the moment you're fighting or whatever you're doing. And this is related to the if you get heals from the other characters, okay? Energy recharge also is very important, because this one for me is 105%. You can check in here. Energy recharge increase the amount of energy regenerated with each elemental particle and elemental orb obtained. The higher the value of this number, the more energy is regenerated. So it's clear, you regenerate faster energy. That means guys, you can cast faster the skills. No, you'll have more energy to cast them. And then reduce CD or reduce cooldown, decrease the cooldown, CD means cooldown, for the character's elemental skills and elemental burst. The higher the value, this number, the shorter cooldown. So this also is very important, especially when it comes to dealing damage. The higher the reduce cooldown, the more often you'll be able to trigger your ultimates, your abilities, okay? Powerful shield is related to shielding effects, okay? So this is useful for characters that are more tanky. They use shields like Geo class, okay? So this will absorb by percentage the damage that you take, okay? The higher the value, the more damage shield can absorb, okay? Then you have elemental type like pyro damage bonus, okay, resistance. So what the damage bonus and resistance, damage bonus, it means the amount extra damage you do that specific type of element, like pyro is fire, hydro is water, and so on, okay? Dendro is nature, electro, you know what it is, cryo is frost, geo is earth, and so on, okay? And physical also damage. And then you have the resistance. So one is the damage increase by a percentage, and the other one is the resistance to those elements. So if a monster has that type of damage to you, you have a specific percentage to resist that. So you'll take less damage from that specific type of resistance. So having higher resistance to those different element stats, it's also important. As you can see me, I have 15% to all, and you're gonna see how you can achieve that, okay? And for physical damage, I have a physical damage bonus, which is very important also, by 30%. So you're gonna see how you can increase all these stats. So let's start first. One way to increase these stats, especially the basic stats, guys, is leveling up. So you need to level up and ascend your character. Make sure you get good characters like 4 stars and 5 stars is the best right now. So you can get that with Primo Gems, you can get them from events. Okay, so at least the 4 stars from events. So yeah, let's see, also from completing some story. So let's level up. Right now mine is level 22, and you can use this books, okay, experience book. So let's see, I'm gonna use these ones. Let's try to get it. And you're gonna see all my stats will increase. Okay, let's get maximum. Okay, this will consume also, by the way, some of your currency, the gold or however the game currency. So level 34, you can see the base stats always increase. So one way is leveling up the character and advancing, promoting, because a specific level you have to also promote, and I'm gonna show you how you can get that. So max HP, attack and defense, those will increase from leveling up. And once you reach a cap, let's see, I'm gonna show you for, I think for this character I have, okay, see this one is level 14, let's get him to level 20, And after you reach that, you need, see, max level 20, you need to promote, okay? To ascend or promote. So right now it has 0 stars. After I ascend or promote him, he will get more stats, more power, and you can further level him up. So now he's 1 star. So that's why having characters that can be promoted higher, so they have more possible stars, are very important. So that's why you should try to get a 5 star character. That means that character can be level up higher, so you'll get more stats. So that's why it's important. So how you can get the upgrading materials to promote, to upgrade? Okay, so I'm gonna show you. You'll find in the first initial town, okay, in here in Mondstadt, you just go to the lady that has this, okay, the crystal shape or the diamond shape, okay, that's the NPC. So you go there and you can buy them. I'm gonna show you also. Okay, so let's see. I wanted also to test, because I'm gonna show you also other ways to get to increase your stats. So weapon, okay, weapon, it's another. Weapons also are very important. Also, they have different stars, as you can see in here. Like this starts from 1 star, which is the lowest quality, and then 2 stars, 3 stars, and 4 stars. So if you get a 4 star, you can get from completing the story, if you explore the world, and a 5 star is the best to get, same like for characters. And then once you get at least a 4 star, guys, you should start to level up to level 20 or higher. For example, for this one, I'm level 14, so if I want to level it up, sorry. Okay, let's go to that character, because it's on different character. I cannot level up on... So it's on this character. So weapons are also another way to increase your stats by a lot, okay? So you can enhance them, okay, using different materials. You can use weapons and armors, lower tier that you need, or you can use these crystals, okay? That will give you lots of levels. The higher the quality, the more experience for your weapon they will give. So this one, let's see how many I need. So level 20 will be max, and then I have also to unlock. So let's enhance, and this will increase, see, the base damage. So that will increase your damage by that amount, so it will add up to your total damage. And also it has some extra stat. This was energy recharge, okay? And after, guys, you reach max level, you need to promote. And see, you have these materials, ascension, and these ones you can get from, you see, domain of forgery, ruins of, so it's a type of dungeon, okay? Or purchase from souvenir shop in Mondstadt. Okay, so let's do that. So also in Mondstadt you'll have those, you'll have that souvenir shop. So let's ascend, and this will increase, see, the mace, and it's 1 star now. So maximum for this weapon also can be promoted to 4 stars. And then I can continue to level up. So level up, get a 4 star weapon or 5, and level it up, and then ascend it, okay? Let's go back to my cryo dude. So this one is already level 20. At level 20, if you want to enhance further, okay, oh, I need, so I can get, for this weapon, I need to go to Liyue. This is the next town, guys, to the souvenir shop. So that's why I'm gonna show you after. But let's see if the attack damage, because I want to test, if the attack damage, the pure, the base, the flat attack, will increase also the damage of the skills, the elemental skills, okay, the attributes. So right now I'm gonna equip first a lower tier weapon, okay? So let's put this sword, fast equip, boom, switch, and there we have, now we have this one. Let's go and let's attack a monster, and then I'm gonna do the same process with the leveled up higher tier weapon. Okay? Oops. Sorry. Okay, so they are here. Okay, level 20. So let's do the cryo attack. 165 for both of them. And now, because I cannot switch the weapon if they keep on attacking me, let's go further from them. So they, I can switch the weapon. So here is the right place. Okay, so now I can switch the weapon. And you'll see, guys, let's equip back this. This gives way more. Fast equip. Boom. See, 86. And also physical damage bonus. So I suggest to get, if you get, if you can, also physical damage or some type of damage increase for more damage. Okay? Okay, let's see. So that will increase by percentage. And now let's use again. So not the normal attack will increase for sure, the physical attacks. But I want to test if also the your elementals attribute skill attack will increase. So let's see. You saw right there 340 something. And they died both. And if you don't believe me, you'll see again for this one. 421. So that's why, guys, you want to increase your attack. That's a good reason, no? Okay, let's finish him. So besides the base attack, the attack, physical attack that you do with the weapon like this, you get increase for all the elements damage. So if I was fire, for example, I'll get higher damage for the fire elements, the attributes that use this, like this one or the ultimates. Okay, now, because some were not sure if that will increase, so that's why I want to test. Now, let's see, another way, guys, so weapon is very important, as you saw, and you have different tiers, you should level up if you get a tier 4, okay, or 4 stars, or 5, 5 is even better, or, guys, another, besides the weapon, and weapons also, guys, they come with, I'm gonna show you, so you can enhance, which will give you higher levels, okay, and ascend, so you can advance furthermore. See, at level 40, it will give me base, higher base attack. I showed you how you can get the materials, and then you can also refine. For refinement, guys, you need to use the same identical weapon as materials, so you need to have doubles, and then you have, see, this, let's say, extra effects, okay? So the current on hit, normal or charge attack, increase attack and defense by 4% for 6 seconds, and max stacks 4 times. So you multiply that percentage by 4, that's 16. This effect can only occur once every 0.3 seconds. For the next rank, I will get a 5% attack and defense every 6 seconds. So this, it's another way to further advance your weapon and get more power, more attack, and so on. So check this once, the refinement system, okay? It's very important also. Then we have very important, guys, the artifact. Artifacts are super important, and you can equip up to 4, okay, for each character. Okay, so, for 5. 5 for each character, and... guys, they are all different and they come with sets. So sets will give you extra bonuses. For example, if you check the ones that I have equipped right now, see set bonus, Berserker, which gives me 2-piece set, critical rate by 12%. So I told you critical rate, it's another very important stats when it comes to increasing your damage, because that will increase the chance to do more that extra critical damage. And then resolution of Sojourner 2-piece set. So I have another 2-piece set from that set, and that gives me attack plus 18%. So that percentage is super important. So I would say percentages at end game are more important than flat attack, or because 18% for example, you reach 1000 attack, 80% from 1000 is how much? 180, no? So that will be higher than 100 extra attack, no? So that's why if you reach 10,000 attack in the future, 18%, that's 1800 increase in attack. So percentage in attack increase is also super important. So sets are, as you can see there, and you can check different types of artifact sets, and also they come with different tiers, let's say. This is the highest I got, 4 stars, okay? Try to get if possible. If not, you'll get them later on, no problem. And also, you can level them up, you can enhance them, okay? And you can use as material other that you don't need, other artifacts that you don't need, and they will increase. See, they have also base stats, like here attack, also physical damage bonus. See the physical damage bonus, that's from the set if I'm not mistaken. Attack, defense, and energy recharge. Let's enhance it. Now it's +5. So try to enhance them also for extra bonuses from them. This gives me now 19% physical damage bonus, okay? So that's nice. And each one, if you check, will give you different, so they come in pairs of sets, so you can check in here, and these are all the sets listed in here, okay? So most sets I have from Traveling Doctor. Let's see what this one will do. So this one will give you, if you have 2 pieces of this set, increase incoming healing. So this is good for healers type, like nature, okay? Nature character, okay? Also, if you have 4 pieces of the set, using elemental burst restores 20%, okay? Let's see another, adventurer. What this one will do? This one, if you have 2 pieces, will increase your max HP by 1000, and if you have 4 pieces, opening a chest regenerates 30% max HP over 5 seconds. So this also will heal your character, the character that it has equipped this set. So it's good for adventuring, and you won't die, no? Next one, Berserker. Berserker set, and I have this piece, see? Critical rate for 2 pieces, I have to equip 12%, and also 4 pieces when HP below 70%, critical rate increase by another 24%. So that's a total of 36% critical rate, guys, when my HP will be below 70%. So that will give me a increase in damage, increased chance to do extra critical damage. So this one is very good for DPS, the Berserker set. Also Martial Artist is good for DPS, if I'm not mistaken. See, if you have 2 pieces of this set, increase normal attack and charge attack damage by 15%, which is a lot. And 4 pieces after using elemental skill, increase normal attack and charge attack damage by 25% for 8 seconds. So that's a total 15 plus 25, 40%. Damage increase, that's a lot, no? So you can check different type. Okay, so another good set, guys, for artifacts is resolution, okay? Resolution of Sojourner, okay? And this one, as you can see in here, it gives for 2 pieces attack increase 18%, and 4 pieces increase charge attack critical rate by 30%. So you have both critical and also attack increase. So this is another set for damage dealers, okay? For bursting attack, high damage. So each set is also good for different types of classes. Some classes are good as tank, like you have, let's see, instructor. I think instructor is the, let me see. Elemental, oh no, this is for elemental mastery. Where is the doctor is for healers. I think the exile, if I'm not mistaken. Elemental burst. No, this is also Scholar, let's see. So check different types, guys, because defenders will. This will be for defense. Braveheart maybe. I don't have many pieces from those. So check different sets, guys, and check their effects. If you want more damage, you can equip for. You have a team of four or more characters, okay? So four characters you can have at one time, okay? So that means, guys, you can take advantage of each of one. You should have a tank, you should have a healer, DPS, and so on. Also, another thing when it comes to characters, very important thing, guys, is, for example, their constellation to unlock, further unlock their attributes, effects, or so on. Like this one, Creo, the critical rate, okay, Chaos normal and charge attacks gain energy effect by cryo and increase by 15%, so you'll do more damage. No, then you have other effects, other for glacier walls and so on. Okay, so here it's another way through constellation to further advance the effects and the skills of your character. Okay, like the talents. Okay, also talents. Okay, you can, after your character ascension reach phase 2, you can level them up for a greater effect, okay? So here you can check all those, what will increase also. So talents can be also further advanced. And another thing to take into consideration, guys, is your party setup. So if you go here, party setup, like I told you, it's important to have like DPS class that can heal, class that can tank, and also you have to take into consideration their elemental effects. If you combine that, I'm gonna do a separate video. Why I cannot go to party setup? It's not loading. Okay, this is weird. Maybe because I'm. But in there, guys, you can get other benefits from having different types of elements into your party. Let me see if I can. From here. So if you mix different element types in 7, they are in total are 7. Okay, 7. Let me see. Okay, now it works. So you can see elemental resonance, okay? So what this is, if you have, for example, 4 different unique elements, so I have 4 different, as you can see, pyro, cryo, earth, and so on, also electro. Because of that, I have all elemental resistance plus 15. That's why I had plus 15 resistance to all these elements, which is important, no? Another, if you have 2 at the same type, you get different effects. If you have, for example, 2 pyro, you get fervent flames with effect affected by cryo for 40%. Okay, you'll get less effect from cryo type element damage by 40%, and 40% less time you'll be affected, and also increase attack by 25%. So 25% you'll do more damage if you have two pyro characters in your team. If you have, for example, 2 water, shooting water, affected by pyro by 40% less time, increase incoming healing by 30%. So this is good for healing. Okay, impetuous wind, if you have 2 anemo or wind related characters, decrease stamina consumption, so you'll be able to, is good for traveling, no, if you like to explore, consumption by 15%, and also increase movement speed by 10%. Shortened also skills cooldown by 5%, so that means you can cast faster your attributes, your skills, your ultimates. Okay, then you have high voltage and so on. So check all of these, guys, because each comes with different effect. For example, if you want to be more tanky, Enduring Rock. Increase resistance to interruption when protected by a shield. Increase attack damage by 15 also. Or Shattering Ice effect by Electro by 40% less time and increase critical rate against enemies that are frozen or affected by Cryo. So if you have Cryo types, okay, Cryo types characters, and you have two of them, then you have extra benefits from using their skills, okay? So you have to take those into consideration. Then you have also elemental combos, but for that it's another topic and I might do another video for that. So let me know, guys, what you think and which you think are the best mixture for the characters, okay? Also best party setup, and what do you think is better to focus on, building up the elemental mastery, like increased elemental mastery, or is better to increase the critical rate, critical damage? Me, I think it's good to increase the flat damage, the flat stat, the important stat like attack, critical rate, critical damage increase, then you have the extra stats that you can also further advance, okay, like specific type of element damage, also elemental mastery is good, and so on. So guys, see you in the next video. Bye.